Harry with the Dirty School of Skate and Sugar Roller Skates. I'm here at the Fountain Valley Skating Center in Southern California tonight to talk to you about the three things you need to know about roller skating before you even get started. This is part of my Quick and Dirty series, where basically I make the video short, sweet, quick, dirty style. So basically you don't have to hear me drone on and on and on for, you know, half hour about a topic that I could really just give it to you straight and quick and dirty. Okay, so here we go. Oh, did you just get roller skates? Did you just buy roller skates? Do you need accessories? Do you not have skates and still need skates? And you're thinking, where do I go? Who can I trust? I need you to go on over to the gals at planetrollerskate.shop. They will take care of you. They've got boots, skates, plates, wheels, all sorts of accessories. So if you're wondering what to get, just mosey on over there after this video. Alrighty, let's talk about the three things you need to know. Number one thing that you need to know about skating once you get your skates on and you're standing is, what should my body posture be? Okay. Let's just do a pilot's checklist from down, from top to bottom. Chin up, shoulders straight across. This is your snack area. Your snack area needs to be tight. Your arms need to be out to your sides. Not in front, not in back. They need to be to your sides. Your palms need to be down. Your hip area needs to be low. Your knees need to be soft. You're going to put your feet in a V position. This is how you're going to start, okay? So every single time you get on the floor, every single time you go outside, you think, chin up, shoulders straight across, snack area tight, arms out, hips low, knees soft, over and over and over. Chin, shoulders, snacks, arms, hips, toes, or knees, then toes, get in a V position. Now, that's number one. Number two, once you're in the V position, in order to get rolling, you have to do something that is simple yet difficult. You have to shift or rock your body weight from side to side. Skating, not walking. It is not walking. In order to go forward in skating, you gotta shift your body weight side to side. Got my body posture correct. I'm down. Now, I shift my body weight to the left. To the right, shift it to the left, shift it to the right. Now, a lot of times you're just gonna see my feet go left and right and left and right. Realistically, what is happening is when I'm down and I shift my body weight over towards my left side, this skate starts to roll and then I send it back to the right and then I send it back to the left. Which brings me to probably the most important thing that you have to know and that you have to do with confidence, with determination, and consistency, which is bend your knees. Skating is done on bended knees all of the time. The more you bend your knees, the better off you're gonna be. Chin, shoulders, snacks, arms, hips, knees, shift, 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 and I'm bending my knees. Now, when I bend my knees, I'm pushing over the ball of my foot. I've got my weight over the top of my skate, the weight over my top of my skate. If you have ever played basketball, football, tennis, volleyball, almost every single sport except aquatics, you are on the ball of your foot and you're shifting the weight from side to side. You have to bend your knees. So many skaters, I see them in distress. They're scared. I get it. It's legit. You're on wheels, you're going forward, you feel out of control, and they stand up nice and straight with their knees locked, and that's when they fall backwards. If you think you are going to fall, you have to get into my patented O position, which means I think I'm gonna fall. Ooh. I get down even lower. I take my fingertips and touch my calves, okay? That's how you can keep yourself from falling. But let's go through it again. I need posture perfect. And then I need you to understand that your body weight needs to shift side to side, side to side, with a bended knee from side to side. If you want it to be smooth, you're gonna bring it up, set it down, bring it up, set it down. It's about your body weight shifting from side to side. It's about bending your knees. And if you can get all that, you focus on just those three things, I promise you, you will get better and better each and every time. Now, if you're new to skating, or you're new to this channel and you haven't seen my videos, the magic word to getting better at skating is practice. I don't need you to skate for 4 hours in one day. I'd rather have you skate 10 minutes every day. I'd rather have you just put on your skates. You can't leave your apartment, your house, maybe you're locked up, I don't know. You're at work, just put your skates on and walk around. Your feet need to feel the love that is your skate, and you need to be at one with them, so when you put them on, you're like, these are so much better than shoes. Okay, I need that to happen for you, and I need you to practice. Now, on the note of practicing, I can't have you get crazy. I can't have you critique yourself all the time where you're coming at me and saying, yeah, but Dirty, I tried it, I'm terrible. Of course you're gonna be terrible. It's new stuff. We don't learn this overnight. I just need you to practice, and don't forget to have fun practicing. That means you have to have a sense of humor about it. So if you screw up, just get up, laugh, try it again, try it again, try it again, all right? So skaters, I hope that worked for you. And that's all I got. It's late night, I gotta go. Go practice, and we'll see you next time.